Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. It's Rad. Welcome to Rad Kutarot, and this is going to be a Pisces Sun, Pisces Moon, and Pisces Rising weekly tarot reading, March 25th to March 31st, 2019. And while I'm shuffling the cards, I want to remind you once again that this is going to be a general reading for Pisces star sign. And for that reason, this reading is going to resonate in a different way and as well in a different level with every single different Pisces. So if you want more personal touch, however, meaning your personal situation to be analyzed by me through tarot, just like I'm doing for the few examples in this video, then that is the subject of a private reading. And for such, you can check out my website, which is listed down below in the description of this video. And there on the very front page, you can find full list of my services as well as their pricing, starting from just as little as $12 for recorded video and $15 for a private call reading. So that being set aside, moving to the Pisces weekly reading, the first card, which is marking the topic for your Pisces week, that is going to be the Two of Swords. Followed by the second card, which is the negative approach toward the topic here, that is going to be the Ace of Wands. Third card that we do have, that is the positive approach toward the situation, that is going to be the King of Wands. And the last one that we do have, it is the final outcome of growth. Should you follow here the guidance of Tarot, we do have the Death card. So once again, Two of Swords as a topic of your week, followed by the Ace of Wands, which is the negative approach toward the situation. Then it is the Knight, the King of Wands, excuse me, as a positive approach toward the situation, and the Death card at the end as a final outcome of growth, should you follow the guidance of Tarot. So it does look like that with the Two of Swords as a topic, it seems that this week is going to face you with a situation that you're going to be quite baffled of. That is because everything will hang on a precious equilibrium, that being said, and the right decision how you should proceed with that situation could be anybody's guess. That is at least at the start of the situation itself, so you can expect a bit of drama here and there, and as well a bit of dilemma. But the thing with the Two of Swords is that if you allow yourself to be patient and wait, the right choice is going to become obvious with time. Usually the Two of Swords manifests itself when there is a lack of information or something important is about to happen, and as soon as it happens, then one knows what one needs to do. So that should be a week where you carefully analyze your surrounding, your environment, the people that you interact with, and so on and so forth, so you can place an accurate diagnosis upon your situation in your life, and from there, you know, make the obvious right decision instead of the impulsive one. The accompanied card here, this is going to be the Magician. The formation that these cards are making is active supporters. And with the Magician card here, we're talking about something very, very important that is about to be decided upon. And in this situation, you have to incorporate your personal sovereignty as well, your iron will. So you should not accept no for an answer or a failure as well for a outcome. But rather, if things aren't working well right now, it is best, you know, to wait that new circumstances to happen here and there. And with these cards as well, guys, if you don't have the determination to support your actions behind, it's no point acting at all. And as well, best results are to be reached and achieved as well if you put your communicational skills into action, meaning research, ask. You know, you're baffled about a certain situation, reconnoiter about it. For those which English isn't native, reconnoiter is the same thing like researching, but instead of reading as a research, you ask about it. That is about reconnoitering, I think, or at least this is what the dictionary, it's written in the dictionary. So yeah, ask about it, guys. You're baffled about that project, ask your colleagues about it, ask your boss about it, or your supervisor about it. Ask questions. That is from imperative importance here for throughout the week, so you can finally overcome that equilibrium which is obstructing you for seeing the right decision for yourself regarding your career or regarding your relationship. It could be as severe as you may baffle yourself, should I stay or go, you know? And at the start of the week, you may not be able to answer that because either of these decisions are gonna have equal pros and cons. And that is totally fine, you know? You will need a couple of days or maybe 1 week, which is this week, to decide which thing to do, you know, to stay or to go. The second card, which is the negative approach toward the situation, Ace of Wands speaks for a premature action, striving for the new, you know. For example, in this situation, should they stay or go, striving for the new, you break everything with the past, you just go and you don't stay, and you hope for new enterprises to happen here and there, like you are to embark a brand new life. Well, with this card, are you sure that this new life is going to be exactly what you want? Ace of Wands into this position, it does ask you to put a second guess, you know, put a second thought behind your actions. Don't give yourself away to the temptation and to seemingly gainful enterprises in front of you, as well as, you know, hoping for the best and having nothing to support that hopes as well. Also, the Ace of Wands, it does represent the, in this position, that is, in the negative position, it does represent that you did what you could until this very moment. And now all that you need to do is rather like observe and wait, and like I said, reconnoiter as well, to find out how best to utilize your means, your capabilities, or your aces. That is, for example, you can hold a huge ace regarding your relationship, and you have to sculpt the right moment to use that ace. The accompanied card with the Ace of Wands, that is going to be the King of Cups. We do have a active enemies, and the King of Cups here points that you should adopt a very balanced position and do things only when you are experienced enough, that is. So whatever decision you are to make, it should be a very well balanced decision. And with the King of Cups into that position as well, you may need some help, especially as a combination with the Ace, or even with the Two of Wands, or with the Three of Wands, these prime fiery energies, definitely asking questions and seeking wisdom and guidance from someone that is more experienced than you is going to breed a huge, huge results, far better results than if you try to face that plight or a stagnated situation on your own. Stagnated, I mean that not knowing what to do and how to approach your situation in general. So what I'm trying to say here, Pisces, is that there is no need to turn off a helping hand, because for what it seems, such a hand is going to come around as a insight, as a guidance, you know, or a very sound advice as well. And you gotta listen to it, but not necessarily act upon it. That advice should serve you as a additional information rather than a green light for you to incorporate your actions. So that leads us to the third card, which points what is going to be the appropriate actions regarding the situation. We do have the King of Wands. Very baffled card into this position as that follow-up. Here, the most strong incorporation of the King of Wands is that the King very well knows what they are after. Not just what they want, but what they are after. The King very well knows the criteria that needs to be accomplished. That being said, the whole reading could point to unwillingness you to accept a certain defeat, or to accept that things are to happen under certain circumstances which are uncomfortable for you. And that's why you are to stall that situation before you give your yes on a proposal, let's say, or yes on a involvement into a project and so on and so forth, until the conditions are just right. That is because with the King of Wands, you always need to aim, when you do something, you know, to be very effective, to transform your thoughts and your ideas into very, very powerful actions. And these actions can only happen under the right circumstances. So this is how I see you here, Pisces, to negotiate and establish and kind of try to define what the right circumstances are going to be for you, so you can be most effective and efficient in what you do, either regarding career or either regarding relationship. As well, the King asks you to be very sincere, affectionate throughout the week, and have the knack of enjoying life. So going into parties and having good times with friends is not going to hurt you at all. The accompanied card here, this is going to be the Three of Wands, which is the formation is active friends. And my God, the more stagnant the situation is, or the more complex the situation itself is, the more determined you are going to be to give the most out of yourself so you can reach the best results. So the tougher the situation is, the bigger results you're gonna get at the end. This combination here, King of Wands and Three of Swords, it's a person who denies failure, person who gets more ambitious when they see no breakthrough, when they see no progress at all, but also person who recognizes the right timing and the right options available, person who does not strain themselves, or rather swipe themselves with others' opinion, but they very well know what conditions they require, as I said, to achieve one goals. That person is you, or should be you, Pisces, throughout this week. So do not bend yourself, or do not bend your knee under mental cruelty, under a criticism, if you want to say it that way as well, and especially under a poignant experience from the past that could obstruct you or petrify you to make any actions forward, or it could kind of like scare you and provoke you to do premature actions into a certain direction. Like I said, patience and gathering any information, it is what is required, so at the end you can make the best accurate decision or best productive decision for yourself, how you should proceed, either with your marriage, career, relationship, friendships, you name it. And should you follow all that, should you accomplish the guidance of tarot, the last card that we do have, which is the final outcome of growth, that is going to be the Death card. So finally we are seeing change is happening. As a matter of fact, with the Death card, it does look like that. How can I put it into words? Things are going to be moving around, and you are to recognize what needs to be changed so I can be replaced into a more productive, replacing one project for another, replacing one relationship for another, replacing, you know, one routine into one relationship with another, and so on and so forth. But with this card, you are to recognize at the end of the week what till this very moment hold you down and how you have to liberate yourself from it. That could be a person, it could be a habit, you know, it could be a performance, it could be as well a conditions that you are creating for yourself, but you are to make a clean break with some noxious, for example, habits, people, or circumstances in your life which are to open room, a new life to spring in any form from it. And the accompanied card, that is going to be the Page of Swords. Formation is passive neutrals. So that is not gonna close you at all. What I mean is that you will still be eager to explore the world here and to be apprenticed into someone or into something, learning constantly new things and discovering as well new sources of help. Your intellectual agility is going to, reveal you the way moving forward toward more productive heights, which are going to be the core of the change here happening in your life, which with this formation definitely is going to be a change for the better. The very least, with these couple of cards at the end, many noxious people in your life which are making you feel bad, despondent, poignant, you know, and feeling like a crap in general are no longer be relevant there, and their opinion will simply stop matter, and it stop going to be a fulcrum of yours, a fulcrum of comparison of yours. So Pisces, it looks that this week is a important week for you, as a matter of fact, very major one, because you will have to make an important decision how you should proceed from now on. And as an important decision, it is best, you know, to before you decide what to do, to consider all points of view. And at the start of the week, you don't know all points of view, you don't know all options available. That's why you have to ask. If something is baffling you, ask about it, you know, ask for an information. And information is gonna come to you, which again is going to make the right choice pretty obvious to you. So that being said, guys, this was your weekly tarot reading for Pisces Sun, Pisces Moon, and Pisces Rising, March 25th to March 31st, 2019. I hope you enjoyed it and you liked it. And once again, that was a general reading for Pisces Star Sign. And for that reason, the reading is going to resonate in a different way and level with every single different Pisces. If you want more personal touch, meaning your personal situation to be analyzed by me through tarot and to give you a prediction for its future, that is the subject of a private reading. And for such, you can check out my website, which is listed down below in the description of this video. And there you are going to find on the very front page full list of my services, as well as their pricing, starting from just as little as $12 for recorded readings and $15 for private call readings. Rad signing out now. See you next time. Bye.